So we're lucky to have Risco and Jolie Bitt to join us to talk about the changes IBM are making around the deal ready CBR processes and how we can kind of streamline that and make sure you're maximising margins. So we ran a webinar with Graham Horncastle on some of these programs a few weeks ago, but I want to have this, I'm sure you want to have this a bit more interactive, so any questions people have got. Because the aim of the session, again, is to understand how CBR is changing, making sure that you guys are maximising margin every deal you're doing, and understanding kind of the people that are here to help you if you've got anything. So I'll pass it over to yourself, but thank you for joining us.
Thank you. So welcome to this session about the sales programs. As you know, IBM has been having value programs for business partners to reward. We are building a new ecosystem worldwide. We have a big team in worldwide to work on a transformation to prepare for the new ecosystem, including business partners with other business models than only the existing. And we try to align and simplify and make it very accessible to everybody. That's what the worldwide team is working on. And so we have this big project team, and we were very lucky and happy to be able to launch a lot of things on the 15th of October. A lot of changes, simplifications, simplified transformation. And so I have put slides together to tell you about all the changes and the purpose of it, and also how you could earn more if you use all this. So let me give you first the starting point. Last year, I think, was the first time we were really serious about getting the feedback in an official way from the business partners. We started with Net Promoter Score, asking questions to the business partners. You could provide your feedback, and then based on that, we were deciding about projects, what needs to be done. And what you see here is like the feedback we got, and which was a basis to start our projects on. And so you see, simplify your quotation process. It's all about reselling, making sure that you can resell more and faster and earn more, become more profitable. Simplify the management of registering an opportunity. And probably you know all that opportunity creation is the basics to be able to earn incentives. For, and I will talk about that later, but we have done that all over many years as a basic. You register your opportunity and you can earn something. And over the years, we always got the feedback, try to simplify that because it's costing us too much administrative time. So we have worked on that. And simplify the sales incentive programs. So based on this feedback, that big worldwide team started to work on the projects and we voted about it, what is the most important. And it resulted in four basic things essential for reselling. And so we have four steps. And at a certain point of time, we said it's the 4x4 project. Nobody understood, but it is because we have four steps. And we have a special website about that, where we have an enablement deck of everything we are doing with these four steps. So the 4x4 partner engagement initiative. And I will show you the high level about it and then go in a bit more detail what it is really. So step one is really streamlining the resell authorization. For many years, we had, and we started that in 2010, authorized distribution, authorized reselling. To be able to resell IBM products, you had to have skills or a solution, certification or an approved solution. And we said, no, we want to make it more easy for business partners to expand on the products they are reselling without have the condition to have the certification or the solution. So we remove that. We streamline it. So on the 15th of October, we have started with the so-called open zone. You don't need to be authorized for a product group anymore. You don't need the certifications anymore or the solution to be able to resell the products. So that's step one, streamlining. And be aware, you can start reselling, but you don't have access to the incentives. So you can start reselling for the product groups which are in your business partner agreement. If you want to earn the incentives, still we ask for value. So we are checking if you have skills. So step one, streamlining resell authorization. Step two is that we implemented quick price. We wanted to have something where a business partner could more autonomous check what the best price was and in a faster way. So we implemented for most of the products and the others which are not included yet, we will include later on, the possibility to ask for a price which is lower than the list price, and you don't need to go to a special bid for a steeper discount. So if you are okay with the quick price, you can check it yourself what the quick price is. And if you are okay with that, you go to your distributor and you order with the quick price. So very easy for business partners to find out fast, what is my best price and can I go with this? So that's step two. Then step three, software deal registration. What we wanted to implement is really that business partners get protection if they are on a deal and they want to have a special bid. So at the same time, we want to reduce the number of special bids by quick price, but if you really need it, then what we want is that the business partners with the skills get the access to the special bid. So what we implemented is one deal registration process, which gives you access to the incentives by registering an opportunity, and you get access to the incentives, sales assist, solution, new client, and at the other hand, to special bid. So you register the opportunity, we check if you have skills. If you have the skills, you can continue, register the opportunity, and we check all eligibilities. Customer segmentation, government, non-government, which incentive you can earn, and if you are allowed to ask for a special bid later on. I have to tell you that we have started with this new one registration, but we haven't started yet with the special bid creation only for the ones who have an approval for their opportunity to ask for a special bid. We will start with that in January. That's the planning. So we have already implemented the new registration with software special bid, software deal registration process in MySA. And later on, it will give you also access to the special bid. It's not an approved special bid. It's an approval to request a special bid if you have this approved opportunity. So that is step three. And then step four is that we have improved and simplified the access to incentives. So the margins are still the same. and I will show you that later on. But what we have done with implementing a new version of MySA with software deal registration, we have like removed what you, if you have done this before, we have removed the bond form, budget, authority, need, and time frame, which we had for years as an attachment, where we got loads of complaints about. And so we have now included that in the MySA registration as eligibility questions. So that's a simplification and really an improvement.
Can I just quickly what on the, you know, when you go to MySA and there is a question there relating to like the question on the bank, and it asks you for the contact name, that contact name has to be someone from your company that wants to receive all the email communication regarding the opportunity, who wants to receive the invoice request or any question that we have. Don't put your customer, because if you put your customer name details on it, that's where we're going to send the information. So make sure contact is
that
made clear to even those that are not in this room, because if the customer receives that kind of...
We only got one partner that got confused, but I thought I'll mention it. And also, just going back on the special bid, when you got the approval for it, you got a protection against IBM. So IBM cannot request a special bid on the same customer, because you have the priority to request
it.
And nor other partners.
Yeah.
So you're safe.
And yeah, so it's good you mentioned it, because this is a new version of MySA, and we are still sorting out questions, and we will provide you more detailed instructions with explanations. But it's good to have it now, because you will still be registering opportunities, and we want to get it right immediately.
For that one as well, so that we only get, we have to use that for the special bid, and no one else can request the special bid.
So what you will now see, if you register an opportunity after the 15th of October, is that you get an eligibility decision, also including the special bid. You can still create, without this approval, a special bid. Starting January, we will implement that for every special bid, there must be a business partner opportunity approved. And only for the IBM customer, IBM-led customer types, we approve also special bids from the IBMers. But also for all special bids for a business partner-led and co-led, needs to be an opportunity for the business partner, and even the IBM account do a special bid without it, starting January. So further on step four, incentives. So the bond form disappeared. We have like software deal reg groups, product groups, instead of what we had previously. And that should be giving the possibility that we can faster move, including new products. So going forward, without wait on the eligibility part number list. So these are the four steps. And I'll try. Start with you.
Excuse me, just on the quick price on step two. Yeah. Does that cover all of the part codes?
Sorry?
Does it cover all of the part codes?
No. I'll have a bit more on quick price. All right. And I'll also refer you to this enablement website, where you find more partner education, recording, etc., instructions, etc. So, high level.
Deal specific product with a client, and then you go to add more products and part numbers, you have to redo the whole process again, so you end up with two.
So
is it two separate ones?
It is like we have it now. I don't know if you're familiar with the incentive program. It stays exactly the same. So at one moment you submit it, then it's frozen and we are going to check if it's a duplicate or not.
Yes.
So if you can add later on, that doesn't make sense. So that doesn't change. Yeah. Okay, so 4x4. To give you the picture, what is happening, how this fits together. That's why we have combined all this, because it works together and gives you the option to do what you want to do. So you can decide, I do only reselling and nothing else, or I want to have incentives, then I have to register the opportunity. Do I want to have the option for a special bid? I have to do register the opportunity. If you only want to resell, you can start reselling when you have a business partner agreement, including the product groups and the preferred distributor in your agreement. And if you then want to go to check for a quick price, you can do that. You don't need any skills or anything. You can just check it. So that is all before we are going to deal registration with access to the incentives or special bids. And so if you have a special bid and you process the order later on, then what you do with the including in the order, you put the opportunity number, the solution ID, and the special bid information to receive all that. And for government customer transactions, it's through the distributor. And for non-government, you receive the fee directly as a business partner. We calculate it, put it aside, and you can we send you a request to invoice us. So it's important, and Joe, stay quiet, because what we find often is that people forget to include the opportunity number or the solution ID, and then they miss the margin. And it can happen with the business partner or the distributor sending it to us, but it is important, otherwise you miss the margin. The incentive payment, I already told you, as long as you have that all that information included, we will find then the opportunity and connect it to the sales order, and based on that we calculate what we owe you for that. So that is the whole picture. And I wanted to
Can
go,
I just ask,
yeah.
The reason why we request an opportunity number to be placed when you place the order with the distributor, when the distributor places the order with IBM with the opportunity number, the system match it automatically. So as soon as we receive the order from the vet, the system looks into MyOSA, match the two together, and that calculates automatically the invoice request. So if that has been missed, no one will know what's happening with your order. The only time we will know is when you come to me after 3 months, I'm not getting any payment. That's why it's so important to have the opportunity number. Because yeah, as soon as you place the order, it hits our system, within a day or two, you can call me and I can tell you how much is the rebate you're going to be expecting.
Okay, yeah. A lot of details about this, but I would like to go through the topics which are important and new. You see a lot of new things, all implemented on the 15th of October. So I will give you a bit more detail on the four steps about streamlining resell authorization, quick price, a couple of slides, software deal registration, very high level, and I will want to go through once more to through all the incentive programs and the margins and what they are rewarding for. So why IBM is streamlining the resell authorization? I told you we have that 4x4 project with four main areas we wanted to improve, which are connected. So streamlining, improving the pricing, create confidence with deal registration, enhancing the incentives process. why are we doing the streamlining of the resell authorization? I said already, it's to make it more accessible to also to new partners, but also for you, if you find an opportunity with other products than you used to have the authorization for, that we don't want you to wait until you have the certifications. We want you to start reselling immediately, and then if you think it's a good business, then you can always go to the certification cycle and get incentives. So for existing partners, it's really to extend your possibilities. And for new partners, it's to start faster. So it is, what is it exactly? We are allowing business partners to start reselling software product groups on-premise, Passport Advantage part numbers, when the product groups are approved in the BPA. We are removing, and this was the previous authorized reselling program, CVR. And if you have been longer IBM business partner and you in software, then you know all about this. That's what we are removing with this. So all these criteria. But note, if you want to make the next step with the incentives, you still need to have the skills. The margins, no change. So what you see here for reselling, I've just only taken out the resell margins. So no numbers here. You will see the numbers with the incentives. So only for support provider, that's an, you will get the presentation also. So, and the customer focus incentive, that will still be available if you only resell. So it is a bonus if you do a business with a BP led customer type or a co-led. And you see, we expect business partners to focus on that. And that's why we are trying to motivate you with an higher margin. So you see the channel margin, it's defined by the distributor, nothing changed there. For the renewals, the same, and for software as a service as well. So reselling incentives or the margins stay the same, not impacted by removing authorized reselling. How to prepare for this? Normally we will migrate all your authorizations to your BPA profile, but that takes time. So if you intend to resell in the coming 2 months some other products in a new product group for you, then apply on Partner World for it, please. Because we don't want to have the nasty surprise that you have your order ready and you can't resell because you don't have it set up in your Partner World profile. Going forward, they will all be migrated, but I don't know how long it will take. So here is the process to apply for the product groups. So make sure you check if it's in your BPA, and if not, what you need to do, please. So that was about streamlining the resell authorization. Now the second step. Yeah, I'm not taking the time to let you ask questions, because I think we are a bit tight on time. But you did anyway, so. Okay, so quick price. Quick price is really like to give you a possibility to autonomously check the best price you can offer to your customer in a fast way. And so it's a competitive price for the business partners to order eligible parts without IBM selling a maximum end user price for the quote. So it is really a balance between the list price and what we had for special bids for the product over the years. So we have calculated what an average price could be, and so for all the part numbers we have made that calculation. So all the part numbers which are included in Quick Price right now, they have had that calculation, and you find them when you go to the tool to check it. So it's a self-serve a possibility, and it is you can check it in the partner guided selling tool PGS, and that is accessible via Passport Advantage online. Allows more autonomy for partners. Instantly the price is visible. The opportunity to increase the win rate because you can be faster. If you have to wait a long time for a price, the customer may have already decided something else. So, and the flexibility to improve margin retention. So this is the thought behind Quick Price. And we have started with this, the eligible products. We will obviously expand it later on, but that will be probably next year. New licenses, on-prem software and appliances, and the eligible programs. So the Quick Price orders will also be normally eligible for the incentives. And the incentive will be calculated on the Quick Price. So, and then you see at the right-hand side what is not eligible. So be aware about that if you are enthusiastically searching for the best price and it is not included in here for a transaction like an ELA or customers on the international watch list. So here you see what we do with the discount for you. We have the standard discount for the list price. We have the Quick Price discount based on the Quick Price. We calculate it from there, and special bid, we also have like the instant rebate calculated on the special bid price. And I think you understood in the meantime, but Quick Price is not a special bid. And it is faster, and you can do it on your own. So for everybody, it must save a lot of administrative work. So you can check it yourself as a business partner and then go with the quote to your, or with the price to your distributor. Another advantage,
yeah? Can you talk about that, but nonetheless, all the discount is embedded in the Quick Price. Yeah. So that means we need to be aware what discount that customer is entitled to, and then we...
No. Basically, that is your price. So basically, you know, like with special bid, you're restricted. With this one, you're not restricted. So basically, whatever you get on the Quick Price, that is your quote.
You can sell it.
That's the price to us. And then you can sell it at whatever price you want.
Yeah. Well, because you put the client's details in anyway, so it will know if you're on a band age or whatever.
It starts with that, yeah.
And if it was 100k list price and you got 20% off, you could choose to get 15, 18, 5, whatever off you need.
Yeah. And the other advantage is that for a special bid, you always have to expect an audit from IBM later on, and for the Quick Price, not. So you get it, and then we are like, we are done.
It's not released,
so
knocking on your door by the
year. Okay. How to get the Quick Price? It starts with a PA online, Passport Advantage Online. All resellers who are selling Passport Advantage licenses have access. And you find the partner guided selling tool there. I have only taken a couple of slides here to give you the high level. On that project website, you will find like a more extensive presentation, a recording, and guidance how to access and how to use the PGS tool, etc. So you will find more about it if you are interested in it. And here you see, like, you have to have a PartnerWorld ID, IBM ID, and probably most of you have that already. And you can also go to the eCare team, and here you have further support and also like help and tutorials. So everything is available so you, that you can start it on your own.
Did I hear you saying the quick price, not all the parts were in there yet?
No,
When will we be able to find all the parts that are in available?
I think that we will do an announcement at that time, but it will not this year be anymore. And in that extended presentation, you will find all the product groups.
Send your key partners over to us. We can do it, but it's a manual thing. So if you send like half a dozen or so that you commonly sell, then we can check for you.
Yeah.
But then when we get an extensive list, we can find everyone.
Yeah. Yeah, and yeah, for your understanding, we have like given special sessions to the distributors to support you. So, and we are always providing updates. So, as soon as we have informed Arrow, then they can inform you further also if we have not sent a PartnerWorld announcement about it. Yeah.
Access the partner, just the previous slide, to do the quick pricing.
It's
PA online.
Oh, where we go to my SA.
No.
It's different.
It's
that would be.
Can you just add a tab somewhere?
No, the reason is because, as you know, with the Password Advantage Online, that's where the customer banding is linked to. That's why. We're not sophisticated yet to put the two together, so.
Or the marketing, the co-marketing is one either, right?
I think he's running out of time. I think another reason you're
You know what,
yesterday,
someone asked me what someone in the company said, Tony, can you go and do the GOE thing? Because it'd run out.
Yes.
Or the, I have to do the certification for the government.
Yeah.
And I went into my assets looking everywhere. I spent must be there half an hour, 45 minutes. I'm thinking, I'm sure it was here somewhere last time I looked. I couldn't find it.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah,
these are good. These are good comments. So please provide your feedback to NPS. And, you know, then we assess what the highest priorities are. Okay, let's continue. So software deal registration, step three. So what is it? A software deal registration, one per opportunity in MyRA, and you were used already to that for Sales Assist, CVR Sales Assist, CVR Solution, and CVR New Client. And now we have added special bid pricing. So one opportunity registration, and then you have access to the incentives and the special bid pricing. And what we do there, and I already said that in the introduction, we check the skills. And we have added there a possibility. So we used to have certifications or a solution, and now we have added also a competency. So you have three possibilities to have skills and to have access to this software deal registration. So we have started that also. Yeah.
So we can have a competency without having the certifications, basically.
You can or.
Right.
Yeah.
So
and if you have all, it's okay. Right. Yeah.
So
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. So.
But actually, I have to say, all right, well, I'm positive. So when I did spend 45 minutes looking at part of it, so I was mesmerized by the new look of PartnerWorld. Mm. And it had all the incentive stuff there, and I was looking at all our certifications, and I was like, oh, wow, you know. But once I
shall we do this afterwards? Yeah? You know, I would like to cover all the topics. So okay. So if you have time extra, please. So software deal registration. We ask you to get familiar with the new way of using MySA, and we are working on more detailed instructions. You have in that, on the project website, you have an enablement deck, and there you find a couple of slides how to do a new registration. But it's not very much in detail, so we are really working on giving better instructions. So, but get already familiar with the new tool, because you have now the skills check, and you have to go to a tab to select it, etc. And like Joe explained, you have to make sure that you fill out all the right information to get it through. So, as I said, on the website you find screenshots, and of course it's very important that you keep registering your opportunities, because it's still the first in for non-government customers, so access to incentives and special bid pricing, and for government we can't do that, and we have to approve everybody who comes in which has like a good opportunity registration. So but be aware, non-government always first in, so also for the special bid pricing, same criteria. So whenever you register an opportunity right now, and we start in January with the special bid pricing protection, then everything which is approved the rest of the year, or what was approved already before the 15th, is still valid starting January when we turn this on, until of course the opportunity is expired. So very important to realize that you have to plan for the future. Even if you are not closing the deal this year, then for next year this is important. So that is the advice, to keep registering your opportunities. So that was software deal registration, step three. Then the incentives. And that's mainly about simplifications, not about the margins. So you see here from to the changes, and it starts with the opportunity registration. It was CVR, now it's software deal registration. For sales assist, you needed a program approval, and now you don't need that anymore. You don't have to go to partner role to get your product groups approved for the program. We check it now when you register the opportunity. And like I said, they are approved for the product group, they are first. So these are the criteria, and they are moving away from the partner world access. The BPs no longer need to apply for CVR sales assist program, and you need to be having the skills, and you have to be the first to register for the non-government. The skills, certification badges, or the CVR solution, or that was what it was, and it's now moved to free possibility, certification, solution, or competency. The revalidation, we did that normally for CVR, authorized reselling, for the product groups, the certification, and we did it also for the programs, but we said we do it every other year, and we didn't do that very often, so it was always confusing. So we are now like fitting it all together. We are checking the competency, the skills, etc. in April next year. So everything you were approved for before we started the 15th of October, that is still valid. And next year, April, if you are missing the certifications or a competency, then you have to make sure that you get it again, or you have a solution. So that is a change. Eligibility approval. We try to increase or decrease the number of days we take to give you an eligibility approval. What you will see when you create an opportunity, you see already a lot of things which we check and which you can see immediately in the system. There are a couple of checks which need to be done afterwards, and you get an eligibility decision email later on, and that's the government check. And also when you have registered an opportunity for a new customer, a so-called prospect, it will take a bit longer because we have to create that new customer. So the product groups we have changed from the product groups as you know them. We have now made them software deal reg product groups to include also the part numbers for special bids. In the eligible part number list, you will see which is eligible for the incentive and what is for special bid, etc. So in the parts list, you can find everything. Only partner, the customer selection, that has changed. We will provide a list if you are entering the customer number, then you can select from that list. So that is a change also. We had always the selection on name. This is more in line with, if you are familiar with it, with SaaS deal registration. It's a bit similar. So we are aligning that. And the band form, I've already explained, that is what we have removed to make it simpler. We have now a couple of questions within MySA, within the opportunity registration. So,
do we still have to declare a customer's contact details?
Yeah. And you see these couple of slides also with screenshots, but we will have more detail, so with more explanations. So that were the four steps, and then we were having the incentives. So let me go through it, the different programs. This is our most popular program for many, many years. It was called before SVI, Software Value Incentive. Started in 2006, we changed it 2 years ago to CVR Sales Assist. And the principle is still the same. We want to reward for value you bring by bringing us new opportunities and the sales of effort so that it is closed with IBM software rather than competitive software. So really convincing the customer to buy IBM software and doing all the sales effort. And you have to prove that for government customers afterwards. So register the opportunity, give all the details. We can do a check if it's a new opportunity, if it's really value add, etc. And we give you an eligibility decision. And if you meet the criteria of the program, then you will receive the margin via your distributor, if it's government, or directly from IBM, if it's non-government customer transaction. So here all the criteria details about the program, but the principle is really if your sales effort and bringing new opportunities. And we want to reward that. Based on the different customer segments, we give a higher margin and you can be more profitable. So IBM-led customers, you don't earn a lot of margin for your sales effort because that is what IBM does themselves. Business partner-led customers, the margin is for you. We don't work on that. A new client, of course, we always want to have new clients. So the new client margin is based on top of a sales assist program. If you meet the criteria for that and you bring a new client which didn't provide any revenue over the past couple of years, we check that in the system, you get a new client approval, and for a certain time you will have like all the orders for that customer will get you that extra incentive for new client. And you see the criteria, only when we pay for sales to sales assist, you can earn also new client. So that is one of the eligibility decisions you will receive in your email, or what you will be able to check in my sales activity about the approvals. So then we have CVR solution. For this program, you have still to apply on PartnerWorld and provide like what your solution is, description, proof that it is repeatable, put it in the global solution directory, etc. And if you all have that, then you can be approved, you get a solution ID, and when you register the opportunity, then IBM will connect it to a solution ID. And if you process the order and you include the opportunity number and the solution ID, we will pay also for this, so for the solution. I see a lot of people like, can I still follow this? Yeah.
What does that mean at the bottom, where it says meet the compliance criteria?
Yeah. Yeah. So this is all about selling a solution. So IBM software with your own solution on top, services or whatever. If you sell the licenses which are in that solution, we want to see that you provide that at least 10% of your own solution on top of it. Right. So the invoice to the customer should prove.
The last of you are doing a solution.
Yeah. That we don't give like the extra margin for just selling the licenses. And here you find the attractive part, like what you can earn all together on it. And I'm going always to the most right example, BP-led, because that's the most attractive, because we want to motivate you to go there and to make sure that you do all this. And if you do all together, you sold your own solution, you found a new client, you did the sales assist, and you are fulfilling, you can earn the focus. And you see there 15% for solutions, 15 for new client. And here you see a split. It's not and, it's or. It's IBM identified, which gives you a lower percentage. And the 25% you can earn if you identify the opportunity. Yeah?
Sorry, on the CVR solutions piece, do you have to get the invoice or the purchase order from the client, software and services included on the same PO? Some clients you can send them both.
No, you can gather.
Later on do the implementation of the services.
Yeah, you can gather the invoices over a period of time. As long as all the invoices to your customer together prove, like these are the licenses and these are your...
So how far back can you go to claim the extra margin from the solution?
No,
it's going with the order.
The solution you get the payment for the solution. The way the invoicing is when you do the compliance. So once you're approved for the solution, on the operation guide, it will tell you the dates of when the invoices can be for the 10%. But you will get that example when you get approved and we'll send you the operation guide.
So this, I can't fit this retrospectively, so we've done.
No, we have to be given your CVR solution ID when you raise a PO to error as well.
Yes.
Has to be at time for
it. Yeah, and it is an important question.
Well, no, because we do have that. But we've kept the two things separate and we haven't claimed that in quite a lot of our
opportunities.
Okay.
Yeah. That's why I'm going to say read the operation guide.
And you know, the other thing, it's a good question because where was I? The 10%, the compliance check. It's always good that because you get the incentive when you process the order with the solution ID, but then we do a compliance check and we start checking the 10%. And if you don't meet it, we have to ask the money back, and we don't like that. So it's always good to be aware in upfront that you are eligible and that you are aware what this is for about. So you see, altogether, you can earn up to 70%. So it's really like, if you think you are missing an opportunity here, then ask the question, how do I get to this? Yeah. And so a new client you can't influence, but a solution you can, of course. A new client, we check it, and if you're looking, it's a new one for IBM. A solution is in your own hands to build a solution. So very attractive. So, and it starts all with that opportunity registration. So a good reminder how you can be profitable. I have a new program for renewals. We started that in August. I don't know if anybody is interested in doing renewals and if they know about this. We launched the program last year, and we got a lot of feedback that it wasn't working properly. So we have taken all the feedback of the business partners, the distributors together, and we launched a new version in August. And we have now two incentives. One really focusing on the incumbent business partner, reseller of transaction. The reseller who has done the new licenses or the renewals, they can earn more because we are like promoting, and we want to incent business partners who keep with the customer and build on the relationship with the customer and expand it. So that's why we are giving this renewal incentive to the incumbent. And the other part of this is CVR on time. That's also for renewals. The renewal salespeople in IBM are very, very motivated to get everything in on time. So the sales, the orders. And that's why we have now a separate incentive to get renewals on time. And if you are on time and you are incumbent reseller, you even earn more. You can combine it. We have also a possibility if another business partner comes along and finds a renewal sale and brings it on time to IBM, they can earn something also, but it's a lot lower. As you can see in this slide, you see again the different customer types. This is for the incumbent reseller. You can combine renew and on time. You see, IBM led, we do that ourselves, no margin for you. BP led 8%. And for on time reseller, not the incumbent one, 1% and 4%. So this should really answer all the questions we got after we launched last year a program. So you see, that's why it's so important that we get your feedback, because we develop something and then we have to find out if it is really working as it was designed for. And sometimes you have to tweak it a bit to make it work better. So feedback is always appreciated. And then we have an incentive programs for software as a service, long-term commitment, all about ongoing relationship with the customer, like I told you for the renewals. And we have there an incentive for SaaS also. And we implemented last year SaaS deal registration. In the future, I expect that we will have one registration for SaaS, software, and special bid. Right now, we have two. And SaaS deal registration is really also that we want to see that the business partner has a commitment with the customer and stays with the customer and brings us the opportunity, and we reward for that. So here you see year one for the new licenses, just reselling them. But if you have registered the opportunity, you get extra. And you see we have the customer segmentation a bit different from on-prem. And on the right-hand side, it's the renewals. Renew, reselling, and when you have registered the opportunity. And here is the percentage of long-term commitment. Almost there. So these were all the incentives. So for new licenses, we have a lot of them. Sales, sales assist, new client, solution. You saw the big margin. Renewals, SaaS, and then I have this slide, which looks very busy, and I'm not going to take you through it, I think. But if you have the presentation, it is very helpful to really check it out. Like per program, what the requirements are and how we are paying. So it's all about receiving your margins, huh? It's not just like this is available, but this is how you can get them. And then I have some pages with support for the sales programs, with all the links, etc. So I will expect that you send it around or make it available. Yeah. So the simplification transformation website once more. For streamlining reselling authorization, the onboarding teams, so the task IDs, and of course Joe is always supporting with all the questions, and of course Arrow as well. So certifications and badges, you can check there. This is something I wanted to point out. We have just adjusted this, the dashboard for business partners, where you can check your certifications and your solutions as they are currently. And also, so you have a bottom line in the dashboard where you can see your current eligibility. And then at the bottom line, or the top line and the bottom line, you can see what it is for April. So we have now provided that, so that dashboard link is also on the website for the project or of the program. So important that you know your status.
That will give you the gap. If you go to the dashboard, that will show you what will be your gap for April 2020. Now, the good news as well is there is a special team that is basically what I call renovating PartnerWall. So you will see that in future, PartnerWall will be a snake that they will put a search bar that you don't need to navigate on all of them. So they're getting rid of the redundant links and basically putting it to a new generation. So we call it the new generation PartnerWall. So you will see PartnerWall be sometimes going down. It's because they're regenerating it to be in the right century.
Can I make an ask for an app?
Yeah, that well, we might get
that's the third generation. That would take off.
Good idea. MPS.
My ESA version 2. Come on. So we're getting there.
Once you've got eligibility, it's approved for CVR. How long does it last for?
6 months.
And then you can extend it once.
Okay.
But then after that,
does it flag up when it's due to be extended or it's going to expire?
No. What we do is you can extend it, so you register before your previous one is expired, and you mention the current one. We are checking, and we are asking you for sales documents.
Yeah.
to prove that you're really working on that opportunity, and then you can get your extension.
So how long is the extension?
Six months.
Yeah, yeah. It's like a new one. It's like a new one.
Just to reiterate, if you change the parts, if you change any of the parts, you've got to reapply again.
Yeah, it's a brand new one, yeah.
So if you look,
the minute it's approved, it's frozen.
Should we wait? We're on the next session now.
Okay. So that was all.
So Sam, Josie and Dan and Graham did a webinar on this fairly recently that we can send around. We're also recorded this session, we can send it around. But for me, we work with 198 plus vendors. IBM is the most profitable partners. Yes, there are a lot of hoops to jump through at times, but I think we're seeing internally that IBM are listening, are doing a lot to change this. So thank you for listening. Thank you for coming
in
and running this as well.
Thank you. Thanks for the attention.